ओम श्री साई राम। वेलकम माय डियर फ्रेंड्स टू अ ब्रांड न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ इंस्पायरिंग क्लासरूम्स। जस्ट रिमेंबर दोज डेज व्हेन वी यूज्ड टू बुक ट्रंक कॉल्स एंड वी यूज्ड टू राइट दोज हैंड पेंट लेटर्स, द पोस्ट कार्ड्स। गॉन आर दोज डेज। नाउ इन दिस वर्ल्ड एवरीथिंग इज जस्ट अ क्लिक अवे। बट इट्स रियली इंटरेस्टिंग टू नो दैट इवन द टेक्नोलॉजी दैट हेल्प्स अस टू अचीव मेनी थिंग्स सो फास्ट has also undergone a lot of changes. So come on, let us go and talk to our computer science teacher to know more about this. Welcome to this episode of Inspiring Classrooms. Sairam Kattagubriya, ma'am. Means I feel so odd to call you ma'am actually. It is a matter of pride for me that this child who studied in the school has joined back as a faculty and not just a normal person. She teaches maths so well and her role doesn't stop with that. You also handle computer science, right, for higher secondary. She was a very bright student and that she is able to transfer to the students. She is able to motivate them and make them do maths as well as computer science. So I know both are your passion, but what is it that you will be discussing in the class today?
Yes ma'am, as we all know, computer has become a basic necessity nowadays. Yeah. Sometimes I wonder what life would have been without the computers.
Yeah. So you'll be talking something about computer science today. Yeah, we had I think one or two sessions about maths. It's very apt you chose that. But what precisely about computer science is it?
Today let's learn about the evolution of computers over time.
Yes, even computer has changed a lot. Do you remember when even mobile phones and computers, the brick type of phones we had, and from that the sleek phones, and of course computer also. The way the whole system looks like, as an observer, I just know the external things about it, but you will be able to tell us the technicalities also. So stay tuned, my dear friends. Let us get a lot of information from Kattagubriya ma'am.
Let's learn about the evolution of computers over time. Between 1945 to 1956, we had the first generation of computers, which used thousands of vacuum tubes. As a result, they consumed a lot of power and generated large amount of heat. They were large in size and very expensive too. Machine language was used to program using punch cards and paper tapes. Examples include ENIAC, EDVAC and UNIVAC 1. Now let us see about the second generation of computers. The second generation of computers came between the years 1956 to 1963. When transistor replaced the vacuum tubes. This made the computer smaller, faster, cheaper and more reliable. They were more energy efficient, though distance generated a lot of heat. Examples include IBM 7090 and CDC 3600. So now we are going to learn the next advancement, that is the third generation of computers. The third generation of computers was between 1964 to 1971 when integrated circuits or ICs replaced the transistors. This made the computer smaller, faster, cheaper than earlier computers. They were accessed through keyboard, monitor and even they had an operating system to enable it to run different applications at the same time. Examples include IBM 360 and PDP 11. Now, let us explore the important points in the fourth generation of computers. The fourth generation of computers started from the year 1971 with the advent of microprocessor, which used VLSI, that is very large scale integration technology, to have thousands of IC on a single silicon chip. This made the computer small and portable. They were cheap and could work at high speed with a lot more accuracy and reliability. Examples include all the computers you see around you today. Now, let us learn about the future advancement, that is the fifth generation of computers. The fifth generation of computers will be based upon artificial intelligence. They will use ULSI. That is ultra large scale integration technology, making it even more faster, cheaper and self-reliant, combined with quantum and nanotechnology. Thus, the advancement in technology of computers has helped us to move from big-sized heavy computers to small compact devices, moving from vacuum tubes to transistors to integrated circuits to microprocessor and finally to the artificial intelligence.
As anticipated, you really dealt with the concept so well. Keep it up. But yeah, you have been a student, you know how much we emphasize on values. No, we have our assembly program, we have our charts, concentric circles, everything. So in the class also, I would like to know how you would have integrated values.
Sure. Like computers, how they have been upgraded from time to time, we also should update our knowledge in a positive way.
Yeah, that's very important. The word, no, you added positive, that's important. There are a lot of things. The whole world offers so much for us to learn. And especially as we keep moving in our years, we also should learn what is the current trend. It's not the number of years that matter to you, how much life you add to it, how much knowledge you add to it, and how wise you become over the years is really very important. I'm sure you'll be getting a lot more ideas, my dear friends. Please put them all in the comments below. I would like to remind you to subscribe to the channel and press the bell button for notification. Stay tuned.